At the center of our solar system shines a yellow dwarf star known as the Sun. This hot, glowing ball of gas is the largest object in our solar system, with a diameter of roughly 1.4 million kilometers. It would take over a million Earths to fill the Sun's volume, and more than 330,000 Earths to equal its mass. Any object with that much mass creates a lot of gravitational force, an attractive force that pulls massive objects toward each other. The Sun's gravitational force is so powerful, it holds our system together, keeping every planet and asteroid orbiting around its center. The Sun is also a tremendous energy source. Without it, life on our planet would not exist. But what if one day the Sun vanished, and in its place appeared one of the most destructive and powerful objects in the universe, a gaping black hole? These fascinating cosmic objects create gravitational fields so powerful that not even light can escape. There are several different kinds of black holes, which differ in mass, size, and origin. The most common in our universe are stellar black holes, created when a massive star reaches the end of its life. Throughout a star's life cycle, it may expand, cool down, and change color until it eventually runs out of fuel. When this happens, particularly massive stars explode in brilliant cosmic events known as supernovas. Sometimes, a supernova leaves behind a stellar remnant that collapses into a tiny, extremely dense region known as a singularity. Around the singularity forms a spherical, critical boundary called the event horizon. The event horizon is sometimes known as the point of no return, because the escape velocity at this point is equal to the speed of light. When an object crosses the event horizon, it falls toward the black hole's singularity and, as far as we know, will never return. Some stars can supernova and form a black hole, but not every star is massive enough to create one. Astronomers often measure the size of stars in relation to our Sun. A star must initially be at least 8 times more massive than the Sun to supernova, and at least 20 times more massive to create a black hole. In other words, our Sun is not massive enough to trigger a stellar explosion or collapse into a singularity. As far as we know, the chances of a black hole actually forming at the center of our solar system are slim to none. Let's imagine a different situation. Instead of a supernova creating a black hole, suppose our Sun suddenly vanished, and an equally massive black hole appeared in its place. Most black holes are many times more massive than the Sun, but this hypothetical black hole would just have one solar mass, making it the smallest black hole ever discovered. In reality, the lower limit for the mass of a black hole, once it has finally formed through the evolution of a single star, is around 2.5 to 3 solar masses. But in principle, a black hole with one solar mass is structurally conceivable, perhaps just very unlikely to actually exist. There's ongoing debate about this topic, especially given the theorized existence of primordial black holes, which may get a lot smaller. Black holes are already much smaller in diameter than the stars that create them. The first widely accepted black hole, Cygnus X1, is 21 times more massive than the Sun, yet its event horizon is only about 124 kilometers in diameter, which is less than 1% of the diameter of Earth. When a stellar black hole forms, the original star's mass is condensed by gravity into a tiny singularity. With all that mass compacted into a small area, black holes are some of the densest known objects in the universe. The event horizon of a black hole with one solar mass would stretch just 6 kilometers in diameter. That's over 2,100 times smaller than Earth, despite being 330,000 times more massive. Such a small black hole would pose little direct threat to our solar system. Despite popular myths, black holes are not cosmic vacuum cleaners, constantly sucking in matter from across the universe. If an object gets close to a black hole's event horizon, it may experience extreme tidal forces capable of distorting matter. But at great distances, a black hole's gravity is similar to other objects in space. According to Newton's shell theorem, symmetrical spheres influence objects as if all their mass were concentrated at one central point. In other words, whether a star's mass is evenly distributed or packed into a tiny singularity doesn't matter. Its gravity influences external objects in the same way. This means that black holes affect objects far from the event horizon, like stars of equal mass. A black hole of one solar mass may hardly change the structure of our system. Each planet would keep orbiting this black hole at the same distances they orbit today, though the vanishing of our Sun would have other consequences for the solar system at large. At all times, the Sun emits a flow of charged particles called solar wind. These particles extend beyond the boundary of Pluto, creating a protective bubble around our solar system known as the heliosphere. this vast region of space is dominated by the Sun's magnetic field, which shields our solar system from interstellar radiation, like high-energy cosmic rays. Without the Sun's protective influence, cosmic rays may freely enter our solar system and increase radiation levels on all planets, including Earth. Cosmic rays may also ionize planetary atmospheres, altering climates, weather patterns, and atmospheric chemistry. While our solar system may not fall to pieces, losing the heliosphere would have far-reaching, long-term consequences for our solar system and life on Earth. The Sun defends us from interstellar radiation, but it also creates radiation in the form of light and heat. Like all main sequence stars, the Sun produces energy through a process called nuclear fusion. This reaction occurs when four hydrogen nuclei combine through several steps to form one helium nucleus. Nuclear fusion also releases a tremendous amount of energy that comes in a range of electromagnetic wavelengths. About 40 to 50% of solar radiation takes the form of visible light, which we experience as warm, glowing sunshine. Most of the remaining radiation is released as infrared or ultraviolet waves that are either too short or too long for our eyes to see. Unlike the Sun, a black hole wouldn't create any visible light. If our Sun was suddenly replaced by a black hole, it wouldn't shine brightly in the sky or illuminate the surface of our planet. Instead, Earth and every other planet in our solar system would sink into an everlasting night, though not right away. It takes about 8 minutes and 20 seconds for light to travel from the Sun to the surface of Earth. Only after the last photons reach our planet would the Sun actually blink out of the sky. After that, a twilight glow would linger overhead as photons reflect off the Moon and other planets. Once that twilight fades, our planet would finally sink into darkness. Even the Moon would disappear from view, as would the other planets in our solar system. From that point forward, the glow of distant stars would be our only natural source of cosmic light. Earth would not only get darker without the Sun, but it would also experience a dangerous temperature drop. The average surface temperature today is about 15 degrees Celsius or 59 degrees Fahrenheit, warmed in large part by heat from the Sun. Without it, surface temperatures would steadily decrease. Our thick atmosphere may retain some percentage of the Sun's heat, with greenhouse gases like CO2 and water vapor. We also gather some heat from Earth's mantle and core, but neither would be enough to sustain our planet's warm, comfortable climate. Over an extended period, tropical regions would experience a significant decrease in temperature, becoming far colder than they are today. Bodies of water, including the ocean's surface, would freeze over, covering much of our planet in ice. Only parts of the deep sea may remain in a liquid state, insulated by layers of ice and warmed by geothermal heat. On such a dark, frozen planet, life would struggle to survive. A loss of sunlight would set into motion the most devastating extinction event in Earth's history. Photosynthetic plants could not make food without sunlight, so many species would die within days or weeks. Some, like parasitic plants, may survive temporarily without sunlight, but would eventually succumb to icy temperatures and dehydration. The richest ecosystems, like reefs and rainforests, would crumble from the bottom up. Herbivores of all shapes and sizes would starve as plant food becomes increasingly scarce. Whenever prey animals die, predators tend to follow, driving most of the world's carnivores to extinction. A few species may temporarily survive by preying on the remains of other animals. Others may find solace at the bottom of the ocean around deep-sea geothermal vents. But the vast majority of species, both marine and terrestrial, would not survive. Humans may be a different story. If the Sun was replaced by a black hole, our society might continue to function for a short period. It may feel as if we're just enduring a long night, a depressing outcome, but not necessarily a dangerous one, until the freezing climate begins to take its toll. As temperatures tumble, essential pieces of infrastructure would collapse, especially in areas unprepared for ice and snow. Pipelines would freeze and burst. Power grids would fail, leading to widespread blackouts and causing many to die in their homes. Food would become scarce as crops die, animals freeze, and global supply chains fall to pieces. Over months and years, our population would decline dramatically. But a few members of our species may find ways to survive. We may rebuild and restructure our society to live without the Sun's light and heat. For example, we may use nuclear and geothermal energy sources to warm our bodies and power our homes. We may build structures underground to insulate our spaces better and protect ourselves from harsh conditions on the surface. With enough technology, humanity may survive for a time if the Sun was replaced by a black hole, but it would be the most significant obstacle our species has ever faced. Lucky for us, The Sun isn't nearly massive enough to create a black hole, nor is it going to die anytime soon. Not for at least another 5 billion years. While its vanishing is a scary thought, there's no need to worry. Our Sun will keep shining for a long time to come.